bring the action.
আমরা এখন কিছুক্ষণের মধ্যেই একজন বিশ্ববিখ্যাত সাইক্লিস্টের সাথে আমরা আপনাকে আলাপ করিয়ে দেব। ওনার নাম হচ্ছে সৌমেন দেবনাথ। উনি কিছুক্ষণের মধ্যেই বেরিয়ে পড়বেন। এই হচ্ছে অমিতদার বাড়ি, উনি এখানে উপস্থিত আছেন এখন। দ্য ওয়ার্ল্ড ফেমাস সাইক্লিস্ট সৌমেন দেবনাথ, তো উনি এখানে কিছুদিন বিশ্রাম নেবেন। অ্যান্ড আফটার দ্যাট হি উইল বিগিন উইথ হিজ সাইক্লিং জার্নিজ অ্যাগেন। He will probably visit Polynesia, Australia, all those other countries. Currently he's stuck at New Zealand because of the borders being closed. So this is at Mount Rostel. Kiora and Namaskar. Today we have got world famous cyclist with us. His name is Mr. Sowmen Debnath. So first of all, could you briefly introduce us to what your mission and vision is for the future, and what you are doing? What is your plan? What do you do exactly?
Namaste. This is Sowmen here, and I've been traveling around the world on bicycle since 2004, and this journey is. Started for AIDS awareness program and also promote Indian culture. So that's 27 May 2004. I have started this journey from a remote village of India, which is 80 kilometers far from Kolkata. So this Sundarban is a well-known. It is a mangrove forest and one of the largest tiger reserve of India, and that's my hometown. And from there, this journey I have taken India. For AIDS awareness program, because when I was 14 years old, I read in newspaper one man was died by HIV/AIDS, and he was not so far from my village. So that's main intentions behind of this journey, which brought me here.
Yeah. So what are your precautions that you are taking against COVID-19, and how have you reached New Zealand? At a time like this, was it easy for you to get all the permits and everything?
As I am just real stocked here, and when I came from China to South Korea to here, it was really quite a hard time. But while I was here, I was locked down in Christchurch for 3 months, and then it was quite unknown journey, which came here for 2 months and last almost 11 months in this country.
Yeah, so as you spoke about the Sundarbans, and it's like a mangrove kind of vegetation as I can see out here. Just look at the amazing nature. Filled with mangrove vegetation and swampy marshy lands all around. So how is life over there? Is it really simple, and as compared to other places, how do you feel coming out from that place into the open into the world?
Actually, world is always every single way is surprising, and I'm really happy for it, because different kind of culture, traditions, lifestyle, which is always fascinating me. So born in Sundarban, and to come to New Zealand is really quite hard task for me I believe so. And this 157 countries, many cultures, traditions, which is on my journey and which is always a great way to remember.
How did you develop this idea about, you know, cycling around the globe, and like where did this idea come from exactly?
When I was started with this journey from India, then I traveled 28 states and 5 union territory, and then I thought that this journey I will take to whole world. And three main intentions behind of this journey. One is when I read in an article about HIV/AIDS when I was 14 years old. There was a quotation, AIDS deadly in that cancer, and I knew that cancer is the most difficult disease in this world. So that is how it came in my mind to work for HIV/AIDS. And second is I read a book, Amar Bharat, Amar Bharat, which is wrote by Swami Vivekananda, which is really fascinated me to
Amar Bharat okhane ami korechilam je tumi bishwo dekhte jao bharat dekho bharater moddhe tumi bishwo ke dekhte parba ar tumi bishwer jikoni jao na keno shekhane tumi tomar moto kore ekta bharat dekhbe. That is what is the ultimate form in Amar Bharat, Amar Bharat. Swami Vivekananda উনি নিজেই লিখেছেন, ওটা বাংলা বাংলাতে ওনার লেখা। তো আমার খুব মানে মনের মধ্যে খুব একটা প্রশ্ন ছিল যে মানুষটা কতটা কনফিডেন্ট এবং কতটা সত্যি। প্রত্যেকটা ওনারও জীবনে এরকম ভাবে হয়েছে যে গাছের উপরে বসে থাকা ব্রহ্মদৈত্যের দেখা। হ্যাঁ, আমারও মনে হয়েছিল যে কতটা যে কথাটা যে কতটা সত্যি সেটা যাচাই করা। তো সেটা যাচাই করতে গিয়ে আমার একটা বিশ্ব দর্শন
to how he explained that if you want to see the world, see India. India is within world, and when you will go to world, you will find each and every corner one India. So that's my second inspirations of this journey. And third is Bimal Mukherjee. He's the first Indian globetrotter who traveled 1926 to 1937.
Bimal Mukherjee, হ্যাঁ, ওটা আমার third inspiration ছিল। আমি ওনার বইটা 2000 এ পড়ি। And 1926 to 1937, Bimal Mukherjee traveled around the world, almost 80 countries. 80টা দেশ উনি ঘুরেছিলেন। তো তখন তো ব্রিটিশ রুল ছিল, উনি তো বন্দুক টন্দুক নিয়ে বার হয়েছিলেন। তো তারপরে ওনার অনেক মানে ওনার আমার দুটো জিনিস খুব খুব অনুপ্রাণিত হয়েছিল, যেটা একটা হচ্ছে ওনার সব রকম প্রতিবন্ধকতাটাকে সামনে নিয়ে এগিয়ে চলা, মানে সামলে নিয়ে এগিয়ে চলা। আর দ্বিতীয়টা হলো ওনার প্রত্যেকটা জায়গা প্রত্যেকটা মানুষকে ভালোবাসা। হি ওয়াজ ফলিং লাভ ইন এভরি প্লেস, মানে যেরকম ভাবে আপনি আমার দু চাকা দুনিয়া যদি পড়েন, হ্যাঁ, ওখানে উনি সব জায়গায় গিয়ে ভালোবেসে ফেলেছে। দ্যাট ইজ অ্যামেজিং থিং। হ্যাঁ, আমি হয়তো সব জায়গাকে ভালো লেগেছে, কিন্তু সব জায়গাকে ভালোবেসে ভালোবাসতে ওরকম ভাবে পারিনি। সেখানকার মানুষরা ভালোবেসেছে, বা আমি তাদের ভালোবাসার দানের তো প্রতিদান হয় না, তাদের ভালোবাসার আমি চেষ্টা করেছি একটা যতটা পজিটিভলি একটা ইমপ্রেশন দেওয়ার। কিন্তু আমার ভালো লেগেছে সব জায়গা। আমার যদি কেউ যদি বলে যে দ্বিতীয়বার তুমি বিশ্বভ্রমণ করো আর আমরা স্পন্সর করবো, চলুন। হ্যাঁ,
and his book was republished in 1998, I read it in 2000, so which is really fascinated this book. And and I thought that I wanted to see the world and convey this message.
So apnar koto din hoye gelo? Acha আচ্ছা আচ্ছা তো অকল্যান্ড আপনার কিরকম লাগছে অ্যাজ কম্পেয়ার টু আদার সিটিজ?
ভালো লাগছে, ভালো লাগবে না কেন, ওখানে পুরোপুরি লাইফস্টাইলটা অন্যরকম এবং সময়টা শুধু ঠিক যাচ্ছে না আর কি, মানে সময়টা বলতে কোভিডের জন্য অনেক প্রবলেম ডিফিকাল্টিস আছে, তো সেগুলো নিয়ে মোটামুটিভাবে চলতে হচ্ছে। তো আমরা কোন দিকে যাব?
আমরা এদিকে যাব। আচ্ছা, সো ইউ ক্যান ইউজ দ্য ফুটপাথ অফ ইট। So the manner in which you know you are trying to spread the message about AIDS awareness by cycling around the world, do you think that this is the best method of doing it, or there are other ways of doing it? Because you know this is the age of social media and mass media and web and all that.
Just to start a long time back, and the mode of transport and the way is all changing. So I also talk to different friends and try to do different first of things, my main intention is to youth group. So my group is like 15 to 35. So because I'm a youth and I choose the youth and admissions my journey. So my main target to different school, colleges, universities where I deliver lectures and presentations. So that's the main intentions which I go through, and then others way is different media or social media or different embassies and local Indian communities which is all together trying to the best way to convey this message.
Yeah. So what are your upcoming destinations within New Zealand and beyond? What is your like future plans after this?
My future plan is Polynesia, Melanesia, and that's north of Pacific Island to Australia, and then Southeast Asia to back to India. So expecting 34 countries, 30,000 kilometers to go. So this is my next coming plan.
Yeah. So among all these issues in the world, why have you chosen particularly HIV AIDS program? I mean, there are other diseases also, and there are other problems in human society as well. So why do you think this, you know, particular issue is the most important for you, that you're, you know, traveling the entire world for it?
I told you that when I was 14 years old, I read a newspaper, one man was died by HIV AIDS.
Yeah.
And he was not so far from my village. So that's my main intention, that I wanted to know about HIV AIDS and convey this message to the society. So that's how my journey has started, and until now it's going on.
Yeah. Could you tell us like around 5 to 6 best memories that you have from New Zealand as of now, whatever you have visited?
Many best memories actually. I would like to thanks to Indian communities that they supported me in New Zealand, and I during the lockdown I was in Christchurch, so I have to stay 3 months. So they're all hostels were very cooperative and friendly, and many newcomer friends I met, they were really quite nice to me, and all the way to when I reached to Bluff, I had a wonderful time in Bluff campground where I was staying with Brett, who is a campground owner who invited me.
Where is that, in South Island?
In South Island, end of the South Island, what's called Bluff.
I see.
So then I came back and I was working for Red Cross Society, and
nice.
Then we all the way to went to Kipiranga and Kaitaia. So we were dropping different food and item materials for the COVID affected family.
Oh,
so that was 118 boxes we dropped in different part of North Island. So it was really wonderful time to being and work for Red Cross, almost 100 hours free job.
So now coming to the most important and interesting question, and that is when you spent your 24 days, you know, in that Taliban camp in Afghanistan, so how was it for you, and how were you able to, you know, escape from there? We are, you know, very much interested to know that story.
I didn't escape from them. They released me. So I was caught from the middle of the highway, 146 kilometers outside of Kabul. And then they started to beat it by their gunpoint and backsides. Then I forgot how to speak. I tried to convince them that
please don't kill me, take me with you, and if I'm a bad person, you can kill me later. So then I was blindfolded. It took me a long drive, and where 4 days I was continuously starving, beaten, and then somebody who translated my words to them and tried to explain them, be kind and friendly to them. And that is the way how I try to convince them that I have a mission, and I choose a mission. I have my own missions, and I respect my mission. I respect all over the world any single individual mission. So then last I was 9 days there cleaner, and last 11 days there cook. So ultimately 24 days after I was again blindfolded, and they released me before 16 kilometers before Herat. So it was really quite miserable and very strange experience of my life, and it's made me quite strong enough to fight or to survive or to try to understand what is the world difficulties could be possible. And that's the way how I found myself another journey to Tajikistan, Uzbekistan, Kyrgyzstan, and Kazakhstan.
So while you were in their camp, were you able to, you know, hear all those sermons that they give, and you know, all their religious preachings? And did you see other people also along with you getting tortured along with you?
No, actually I was in different place, and it was a group of people, and I am not very interested to explain all the stuff, because actually it's every people has own way of journey, and I felt that that I'm a guest, how I can complain too much. So that's what I learned from my lifehood, that I came to them, they didn't come to all the way to India to fight to fight me. So it is a way to explain that that I'm fortunate enough to they released me and found myself safe, and then again also for next journey.
Where was this place exactly? Like southern Afghanistan, near Ghazni and all that, Ghori?
It was towards towards Herat.
Towards Herat, yeah. That's where their, you know, hub is. So is Saudi Arabia is the only country which rejected you, you know, permit to do your mission out there, or there are other countries as well?
Actually only Saudi Arabia is a country where I refused to receive a visa. But later on I found out that there has to be now there issuing tourist visa. So now world is became more more kind and more more easy to travel. So I think it is now possible to travel to Saudi Arabia as a tourist visa.
Yeah, definitely, with the government change and everything. So have you cycled through parts of Middle East as well, like Syria and all that?
Yeah, I travel all Middle East, like Jordan, Israel, Palestine, Iraq, Iran, Qatar, Kuwait, Bahrain, Dubai, Oman, Yemen. So that's those part was also quite hard, because that time Iraq had a big war, Syria had a big war, Somalia also had a big war, so Central African Republic also.
I see.
So Africa and Middle East was quite hard to move forward. So
I totally get that. So apart from cycling and, you know, raising awareness about AIDS and all of this, what other hobbies do you have? Do you do like yoga or music or poetry or anything else related to art?
Yeah, I'm an art student. I did my bachelor Bisharat in finance, so I thought that this is I do painting, and also sometimes I read poetry and writing my book. So this is the way how I enjoy the time.
I see. But I had seen some videos of you doing yoga, so I was just wondering if you were, you know, into that as well.
Yeah,
or some other, you know, form of physical exercise.
Yeah, I do yoga, and I also teach yoga.
Oh,
so this is the way how I more interact with the students and youth, and this is the way how I found that the best way how I can share my culture and our identity.
Yeah, you know, like, you know, even I do yoga myself, so when I see that, you know, calmness and tranquility, I know that this, you know, this person also does that.
That's the power I do.
Yeah, think? Actually, yoga is it is a simple process of body to mind, mind to soul, soul to intellect, and intellect to beyond. So it is a way of states and tranquility and clearing your consciousness.
Yeah. So having studied zoology, geology, and anthropology in the University of Calcutta, how do you think it has helped? Like when you are traveling many of these countries, when you look at the rock formations and, you know, geographical terrain, does it you know, help you to go in that state of wow and awe because you studied?
I think almost everything I enjoy the nature.
So your favorite country from among all the travels that you have done till date?
I don't have any special and favorite country. Each and every country is my heart, and I...
Maybe your favorite place, like a destination, mountain, hill station.
I don't have destination. I have a country that is what I wanted to go back. That is India.
Oh. So, what is the best and worst part about, you know, cycling around the world?
Best, it's find yourself. And worst, the difficulties which you need to face, and you need to stand still, to not to move, to go forward.
I see. How many countries have you visited so far? And this is like 150. So hi, welcome back everybody. This is Saptarshi from your very own YouTube channel, that is Traveler in You Vacation Vibes. And right here, over here, we are ending our interview with the world famous cyclist, Mr. Soumen Debnath. So, Mr. Soumen Debnath.
Thank you for being here. And I wish you more subscribe this channel and enjoy your time.